Hello everyone, this is Reverend Dr. Rebecca Michael with my Jesus hat on for part one, and I'm going to do the reading when I have the hat on, part one, that's the word of God speaking. Part two, I'll flip the hat off and have a word with you. What I'm doing here is I'm going back and forth between the Old Testament and the New Testament using the chronological reading plan that I got from ewordfortoday.com, I believe it is. And it's called a chronological reading plan, and I'm alternating between Old and New Testament in the readings because it mixes it up a bit that way. And it is following the actual chronological time frame things happened in, rather than just the sequence of the books of the Bible. And I'm reading from the King James Study Bible, as always. And the reason I'm doing that is because most audio readings that you get are just following the order of the books, and so it's not chronological, so it can be actually quite confusing to start and stop every time you get to a book, and you wonder, well, what happened in the middle of the other story in the other book? But this plan is excellent, and that's why I chose it, because it gives you an audio of the entire unfolding of history. And so it goes back and forth through all the books of the Bible according to exactly how the timeline of things happened in history as the events unfolded in real time. And so this is why I've chosen this one. There are a number of other plans over there, but I thought this was the best reading plan for going through the entire Bible, which is hopefully what happens here. That's the intention anyway. I was doing this for my family, but it turns out that I've got online friends joining me from worldwide in a Facebook group that I started entitled, you can Google search this at Facebook and friend add me there too if you like, Rebecca Michael, you can search me there too. And search the group for the group called Sword of the Spirit TV Bible Studies. That's the name of the group, Sword of the Spirit TV. And you can join us there because I post all the links there in the discussion notes there for each video, and that way people can discuss the videos as well. But I've got brothers and sisters from around the world that are also interested in coming along with this little adventure that shouldn't take us more than a year or two, hopefully, God willing. I mean, life happens in the meantime, but God willing, the plan is maybe even to get done sooner. But I'll see how much time I have to record, but every spare minute I do have, I'll be getting up another video and posting it over at that Facebook group if you want to search Facebook for Sword of the Spirit TV. And so now I'm going to get into part one, which is the Word of God. And we're going back and forth in the New Testament and the Old Testament with this chronological reading plan. And so we just read Luke 1, and now we're over at John 1, because we're going in real-time history as to how this happened, reading the whole Word of God, but in world-time history, the world history, real-time history. And so this one is John 1:1-1:14 in this New Testament reading, and then we'll be going back to the Old Testament for two-thirds, and then one-third will be New Testament, back and forth like that, following both threads in the New Testament and the Old Testament in real-time history. That will be the reading plan we've chosen to do, rather than just all the books of the Bible straight through. And so now to get to the reading for part one here. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. This is John 1:14. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light which lights every man that comes into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. And so that's our reading for today for part one. I have the hat on. This is my Jesus hat that I do the readings in. I start part one with, and then part two, I flip off the hat and say hello to you. And any words that I have that come to me from the reading, any little commentary I might have from previous studies or from my testimony, etc., that I think that I, you know, might be a blessing to share with you. But understanding these are my words now, and this is my testimony, but our testimonies are valid. But just to not confuse that with the Word of God. And so what did I come across here that really lit up for me? And, you know, you can post your discussions over at Facebook for the people that are reading this, are watching this from Facebook, my Facebook friends. You can post discussions of whatever quickened for you right there at the discussion link where I will post it for Facebook. And so the thing that struck me here is that there are many people dissing the Word of God and saying that, you know, the Bible isn't God, etc., but it clearly says here that in the beginning was the Word. And if you look in Revelations a little further here, when we get into Revelations later, I won't do that now, but, you know, one of the names of God is Word of God. You know, he's got Word of God written right across his, I believe it is his thigh when he comes in the second coming. He's called the Word of God. The Word of God is, this is the mind and heart of God, the Word of God. And the Spirit is what quickens and makes it personal for us because we're all different. But you know, it's just like a prism, and that Word goes through us differently because, what you know, the light is like the Word of God going through a prism. And we're all different colors, you know, the way that that light or that Word of God will hit us each differently and uniquely because every one of us is unique. But we're the same in the sense that we're humanity, we're the prism. But you know, when that light or the Word of God hits through the Spirit of God in us, well, then that comes alive and makes us shine different colors, all different colors, but all of that the glory of God if we belong to him. And so the Word of God, you know, Jesus Christ is the Word of God. And the other thing about this that quickened to me is that, you know, it clearly says that the Word of God made everything that was made, and that the world didn't know him. They weren't expecting him to come in the way that he did. Proud, arrogant, boastful men were expecting a king, but not the shepherd, the humble shepherd that he came as, redeemer of the world, as a humble carpenter. That's the profession he chose. But obviously we see here the preeminent Jesus, the God, the Son, the second person of the Trinity, before he came here to be the Son of God, which is the second Adam, the obedient Adam, the Son of Obedience. And through him many, many, many were lived because he's the Redeemer of the world, having paid for the sins of mankind and for the children, the innocent, and with his own life. And so he's the hero. And so that's all I've got to say for today. And next time we'll go back to the Old Testament for two, and then back to the New Testament and so forth, but always in the chronological time. God bless you.